Call this meeting of the Columbia County Board of Commissioners to order for this Tuesday, Election Day again, December the 4th, 2018. You got 1 hour to vote if you haven't already done so. This time I'd like to ask our other short-term commissioner, District 4, Bill Morris, to offer up our invocation. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, Republic of Nation, God, visible, liberty, and justice for all.
We do have a quorum tonight with all five commissioners present. And we have before you three different topics of minutes of previous meeting. We'll take a motion for the first one, our regular meeting of November the 20th, 2018.
Second.
Any items needing any clarification? All in favor, please raise your right hand. The next item is our November the 18th planning advance minutes, the minutes of the regular meeting.
Second.
Corrections? All in favor? Okay. And also of that same date and same meeting, the planning advance executive session minutes.
For approval.
Any clarification? All in favor? We do have one add to the agenda. We'll take up a little later in the meeting. It's a item pertaining to the CSR Development Company agreement with Columbia County, I believe, for road work for Jackson Heights. Again, like to, Mr. Johnson, you have aware of any other changes?
Just one other thing, Mr. Chairman, your approval would be the additional property item for executive session when we take that matter up.
Yes, thank you for that. It is already listed there, but
yes,
we'll have one additional item under the executive session items. Again, like to welcome each of you to this meeting of the commission. Again, these proceedings are videotaped. Be glad to get you a copy of the disc if you desire. Ms. Crawley up here, who is in a new position tonight, done moved up in the world. Mm-hmm. Be glad to see that you won when they're ready.
Sure.
Remind you, too, that you can see these proceedings on the county website after a couple of days. And also that you're invited to speak to this body. If you're not already on the agenda, we ask you to fill out a speaker form in the back, bring it up to the Ms. Crawley, and we'll recognize you at the proper time during the meeting. Also, I believe under presentations, we have a check presentation. Commissioner Richardson, I want to present a check to United Way from proceeds from the Rubber Duck Derby. Do we have a United Way representative here? She is. Now the people that put that event on, I think.
Hi there. We would like to present this check in the amount of $1,032.70.
Sure. On behalf of the Community and Leisure Services Department, we're very happy to present a check for over $11,000 from this year's Rubber Duck Derby. This is Brittany Burnett, the new executive director of United Way of the CSRA, if you haven't met her yet. They were very supportive, obviously, in bringing about a total like this. We also have to single out some others. Our Parks and Rec Department did a great job setting things up out there for us. Mark Blanchard, Joe Jackson, and some guys worked to build the new racetrack, and we'd invite you, if you think 11,000 is a good turnout, to come out and join us the final weekend in August next year for the 2019 Rubber Duck Derby. Thanks so much for being part of our Rubber Duck Derby.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And as mentioned, I'm a new resident here to the community, and we've received a really great warm welcome. Our family has, and it's just a pleasure to lead United Way in the continued effort that we have to help children, young adults, and families really turn their lives around. And we do that through proceeds just like this from the Rubber Duck Derby. And it's gifts like this that last year allowed us to impact the lives of over 218,000 people throughout the CSRA. So know that every single dollar is being put to great work, and thank you. If you bought a duck, if you came out that really hot day and participated, it was really fun. So we're looking forward to our continued partnership. Thanks so much.
Yes.
Poison Ivy.
Thank you, Commissioner Richardson. Then we'll move on to our consent agenda. The lengthy list of items that's been through the proper committee and received the three votes to be put on consent. So inclined, we'll accept a motion to approve all of these items as one vote.
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Any of these items need any clarification? All in favor, please raise your right hand. Go now to our debate agenda. We move to Commissioner Allen.
Yes, sir. On a matter of old business, I would like to make a motion to approve the second reading of Resolution 18-043, Magnolia Valley, Section 2, SLD 502D, upfront poll cost of $3,745.02, an annual utility cost of $1,600.32. Resolution 18044, Magnolia Hills, SLD, 502B, upfront poll cost of $6,554.66, and annual utility cost of $2,800.56. Resolution 18045, Magnolia Valley Section 1, SLD, 502C, upfront poll cost of $2,809.14, and annual utility cost of $1,224. Resolution 18.
Excuse me. $1,200.24.
$1,200.24. Thank you, sir.
Do we drug test, commissioners? I'm just asking for a friend.
I had a mark through mine. I apologize. Resolution 18-046, Four Oaks Section 1 and 2A, SLD 460, upfront poll cost $7,491.04. An annual utility cost of $3,200.04. Resolution 18-047, Brigadier Landing, Phase 1, SLD 516, upfront poll cost of $7,959.23, and annual utility cost of $3,400.68. Resolution 18-048, River Island, Section 2, Phase 2, SLD 409F, upfront poll cost $5,618.28, and annual utility cost of $2,400.48. Resolution 18-049, Eagle Landing, Section 4, SLD 346C, upfront poll cost of $468.19, and annual utility cost of $200.04. And Resolution 18-050, Four Oaks, Section 2B, SLD 460B, upfront poll cost of $4,213.71, and annual utility cost of $1,800.
Second.
6 cents.
Second.
We're going to light up the rest of Columbia County with several streetlight districts. Any discussion of these items? This is a final second reading. All in favor? Very good job, Commissioner. You get to do it again.
Thank you. There were some hiccups there. We'll do better this time. I make a motion to approve the second reading of Ordinance Number 18-13, amending Chapter 34, Environment, Article 3, Soil Erosion, Sedimentation and Pollution Control, Section 3468, Exemptions with an Effective Date of the Second.
Second.
This is dealing with land disturbance permits. I think when they apply and when they're exempt, be more in compliance with state regulations. And this is a final second reading. All in favor? Commissioner Richardson?
I make a motion to approve the Masters Week event agreement with Friends with Benefits Fund, Inc.
Second.
Mr. Johnson, I believe this is a three-year agreement with a cancellation clause that also has a couple of years of renewal possibilities.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman. And this is a large investment on the part of the promoters here. They're wanting to do a longer-term deal so they can start working on the acts for the second and third year this year because of the routing. Fortunately, Masters Week here, which is when they want to do this, is just before a large festival in Florida, so we can get some bigger acts. Last year we had Keith Urban. This year we've announced that Zach Brown Band will be here. And I think the acts will continue to get bigger and bigger.
Any further discussion?
Plan is for them to have multiple events that week.
That's correct. They're trying to schedule multiple events that week. I know our staff's been working real diligently to try to accommodate that. There is a lot of load in for those big shows, and this is one of the ones where, you know, the county really doesn't have anything to lose. We just have to gain because they're renting our facility. They're doing their own production costs. They're paying the talent and our residents benefit, obviously.
And I believe this agreement's got a rental charge and a cost per ticket.
That's correct.
To the county.
That's correct. Again, well done by our staff to negotiate this with a large promoter out of Nashville.
Further discussion? All in favor? Mr. Duncan?
Yes, sir. I'd like to make a motion to reappoint Thomas Schneider and appointing Donald Skinner to the Board of Tax Assessors starting January the 1st, 2019 and ending December 31st, 2022.
Second.
And I believe we have Mr. Schneider with us tonight for a reappointment, also with the Tax Assessor member Charles Sharp, and a new member coming off of Planning and Zoning that will go to the Tax Assessor Board.
Sure. Are you sure you want us to vote for this? Checking one last time.
Any other discussion or comments? All in favor? Mr. Allen, I believe we return to you.
I make a motion to approve Resolution 18-05.
What?
Sorry.
Oh,
that's correct.
I'm so sorry.
Yep.
Oh, you're right.
All right, we'll open.
I withdraw that fragment of a motion.
I like your.
So am I running a public hearing then?
We'll hold a public hearing at this time to consider proposed determination to abandon as a part of the road system of Columbia County, Georgia, a portion of Clanton Road, which is an old roadbed, on parcels 059351B and parcel 059367. Is there anyone here to speak for or against this abandonment of this section of the road? Hearing none, we'll close the public hearing.
Nope.
And move on to the motion.
All right, sir, let's try this again. I would now like to make a motion to approve Resolution 18-051 regarding abandonment of a portion of Clanton Road on parcels 059351B and 059367.
Second.
I believe the resolution of this will be we offer this abandonment to the adjacent property owners, or how will this occur? Further discussion? All in favor?
And an item added to the agenda, sir. I would like to make a motion to approve the agreement with CSRA Development Company, LLC, for Jackson Heights.
Second.
I believe, Mr. Johnson, this concerns a payment on behalf of the developer for some road improvements that was part of the conditions of the approval.
That's correct. Part of the conditions of the rezoning was that they would make a contribution in the amount of $240,000 for road improvements. Staff feels like we can go out and make significant road improvements for that money. We're going to use some in-house labor to do that, and staff recommended approval on this, obviously.
Well, we approve this. Who's got the check?
Oh. 30 days.
It's in the
their
it's
deposit.
Mr. Lawrence is going to bring us a check when we get started.
It's in the mail.
30 days from the start of the project.
Absolutely.
Please let the minutes
reflect. We'll remind you.
It's clearly written in there.
Did you get that down?
I got it.
Thank you, sir. Any further discussion? All in favor? Mr. Driver, that any legal matters arise out of this proceeding so far?
None.
We were close once or twice.
We do have some property matters that we'll take up as open session. Commissioner, well, we have a personnel matter first. I'm sorry. Vice Chair Duncan?
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to approve up to a 3% lump sum merit payment to be distributed to all eligible employees prior to January 1st, 2019, as presented in Attachment A. A cost of living increase to all eligible employees as presented in Attachment B to be applied on the first full pay period in January of 2019. I make a motion to approve the renewing employee contracts as presented in Attachment C.
Have a motion. Do we have a second?
I'll second.
Josh, you want to give us a rundown of how this was reached and how we are with our salary structures and things with employees?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. So you actually have a couple of different items at play here. One is the lump sum merit. As you know, we don't budget for any raises in our budget cycle. We like to see how we come in at the end of the year. Our employees did a really good job of coming in under budget. As a matter of fact, we came in a little over 10% under budget this past year, and that was budgeted funds that were not spent. So again, I think the staff held the line on that. So the lump sum merit payment will be a single check that will go out to the eligible employees. And these are employees that have met or exceeded their expectations on their performance evaluations. We have some employees that did not.
Employee is not guaranteed.
That's correct.
According to their performance rating.
It's according to performance. That is correct. It is a merit payment. So not every employee will receive this, only the ones that are at or above expectations. The second piece of this is the cost of living raise that was presented. Again, we propose this cost of living increase based on our current salary structure. We looked at other counties, and one of the things that we were very proud of is the fact that we continue to serve the citizens of Columbia County with one of the best employee-to-citizen ratios, actually the best of any of our benchmark counties. We continue to have a 1 to about 106 ratio. That's one employee for every 106 citizens. Some of our benchmark counties are half of that. They have twice as many employees as we have with the same amount of citizens. So we felt like it was right to reward our employees again with that, and that will be a cost of living that will be applied to all employees across all employees that have been here for the requisite period of time.
But that includes other agencies such as the Sheriff's Department and
that's correct. The fire department, the Sheriff's Office, that is correct.
Anyone have any questions or comments?
No, just congratulations to staff. Controlling the budget the way they do.
Appreciate it. I think staff works really hard to make sure they do that. Great thing about Columbia County is it's never Christmas in June like some other government agencies where you have to spend all that money at the end of the year or you don't get it. Our staff's very cognizant of the fact that if they'll hold the line on the budget that we may have some money left over to be able to do something like this. So but we don't frivolously spend money at the end of the year like a lot of other places do.
Any other comments? All in favor? Mr. Allen, I believe we have some real estate matters.
Yes, sir. <Excuse me. throat> I would like to make a motion to approve $7,450 to DNA Investments LLC, parcel 17, $6,079 to Eric R. Crossen, parcel 38, $12,950 to David R. and Amy N. Squires, parcel 44. And $5,675 to DNA Investments LLC, parcel 45, to obtain right-of-way and or easements for the SR 28 Furies Ferry Road widening project.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Next, I would like to make a motion to approve $35,000 to GVS Holding LLC, parcel 25, and $100,000. Biggie G. Kerr, parcel 32. To obtain right-of-way and or easements for the Lewiston Road widening project.
Second.
All in favor?
I would like to make a motion to approve $1,510 to Louis J. and Elizabeth W. Frank, parcel 57A, and $500 to Columbia County Board of Education, parcel 70A, to obtain right-of-way and or easement for the Flowing Wells Road widening project.
Second.
Discussion. Mr. Morris, you couldn't get more than $500 out of your old Board of Education?
We cut them a little slack, building a lot of new schools.
They probably need it. All in favor?
I would like to make a motion to approve $7,200 to Jamie E. and April J. Porterfield, parcel 077001B, to obtain right-of-way, easement, and or property for the Jones Creek Force Main project.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
I would like to make a motion to approve $2,432 to Jamie W. Green, parcel 077162, to obtain right-of-way, easement, and or property for the Jones Creek Force Main project.
Second.
Any discussion? Favor?
And lastly, I would like to make a motion to approve $1,617 to Oaky Grove Baptist Church, Incorporated, parcel 077127, to obtain the right-of-way, easement, and or property for the Jones Creek Force Main project.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor? Mr. Crawley, do we have any requests to speak? Do we have any comments from?
No, sir.
We do have one real estate discussion to do in executive session. So at this time, we get a motion. We adjourn briefly to executive session.
I make a motion. We move into executive session.
Second.
Motion and a second. All in favor? We are adjourned briefly.
Could have left. It'd been fine. Hurt my feelings, but it'd been fine.
Call the meeting back to order. Mr. Driver, you give us an update on our executive session.
Yes, that executive session was all about one property matter, and there was nothing closed or abandoned, and there's nothing, no action to take in open session.
Is there any other business to be conducted at this meeting?
One bit of business.
Hearing none and seeing none, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion with you.
I'll second, sir.
All in favor? We are adjourned.